Imagine being able to do genetic screening of an embryo before it's implanted in the womb to reduce the risk of suffering over a lifetime from inherited diseases. That's what ORCID is doing in these labs.
After launching in 2019, biotech business ORCID has been working with patients undergoing in vitro fertilization, or IVF, which is when a female egg and a male sperm are fertilized in a laboratory. Inspired by her mother losing her vision at a young age due to a genetic disease, scientist and entrepreneur Noor Siddiqui set up the business with a mission to help IVF patients make better informed decisions regarding the health of their babies through testing their embryos before embarking on pregnancy. I met with her in downtown Durham, North Carolina.
The testing that's available now on embryos is extremely limited, so it only looks at about 1% of the DNA. What ORCID can do is we can actually read the entire genome.
And how are you able to do that?
When you have an embryo sample, you have about 125 cells on day 5, and the embryologist at the IVF lab sends us about 5 of those cells. And in those 5 cells, you only have about 10,000 times less than the amount of DNA that you would have in a blood or saliva sample. So what we had to invent is a new amplification protocol as well as a new computational pipeline.
The cost for pre-implantation genetic testing ranges from $4,000 to $12,000, depending on the number of embryos screened. ORCID's test costs $2,500 per embryo. The tests look for monogenic diseases which are caused by a mutation in a single gene, and for polygenic diseases which are triggered by a combination of components which include gene mutations, environmental factors, and damage to chromosomes.
On the monogenic side, we're the first company in the world that's able to screen for over 1,200 monogenic conditions at once, right? So these are things like birth defects, pediatric cancers, genetic forms of autism like Rett syndrome. In terms of polygenic risk, that hasn't been possible until very recently, because you had to have sequencing get cheap enough so that you could aggregate these really large data sets of millions of individuals where you can actually build genetic risk scores that quantify genetic risk really precisely.
Are there times when there are different risks? I mean, imagine all of us are at risk for something.
What is really important in our curation process is that we want to alert parents about diseases that are truly catastrophic, life-threatening, very serious, because obviously we don't want to unnecessarily alarm people about genetic risks if they're not very, very severe.
The company collects thousands of samples every week, and the tests are carried out in this lab on the outskirts of the city of Durham. Funda Sewer is ORCID's medical and laboratory director.
All right, Funda, show me what it is that's going on here.
Those are embryo samples. When sample is received, it's frozen and it comes to this area where we accession those samples. Accessioning is registering the samples.
Next, scientists check that the cells have the right number of chromosomes. If the quality of the sample is good, they extract DNA from the cells and amplify the genetic material to look at its variations. That sample is then put into a sequencer.
That sequencing technology will read 99% accuracy of the DNA sequences so that we can read if there's any variation in the genomic material.
How can you tell whether some of these are actually inherited type diseases?
So we also collect some saliva samples from the parents so that we can look at if it's inherited from mother or if it's inherited from father.
This process takes between 2 and 3 weeks. At the end, ORCID's genetic counselors deliver the results to the patients and their clinical teams so that they can decide which embryo they want to move forward with. Despite its popularity among some patients, the technology is controversial. Columbia University professor Robert Klitzman is a psychiatrist, bioethicist, and author of Designing Babies, which explores how technology is changing the ways we create children. I spoke with him about the ethical concerns surrounding ORCID's testing.
I'm concerned, do people understand what they're getting themselves into? These tests, in general, cost money, often not covered by insurance. And so increasingly, breast cancer, for instance, is becoming more disease of the poor, because people who can afford to undergo IVF and screen out breast cancer mutations are ensuring that the breast cancer mutation does not pass to their children. And I think that raises a problem ethically.
How do we help people make choices?
You want to make sure people have the best information that's available to make the choice. And this is where there are problems with some companies that are marketing tests. They may say this embryo has double the risk of getting schizophrenia or getting inflammatory bowel disease. And we call that the relative risk, that this is twice as much the risk as this one. But if you look at what we call the absolute risk, the risk in the population of schizophrenia is about 1%, 1 in 100 people. So the risk, if you have the gene, means it doubles to 2%. So you still have a 98% chance that child does of not having schizophrenia.
When I was in Durham, I also asked Noor Siddiqui about the ethical concerns around embryo testing.
The entire purpose of science and medicine is to reduce suffering. I think that this technology is going to totally reshape how people have children. I don't think anyone should be coerced into doing IVF or using ORCID, but I think it's going to become an option that more and more people will choose because there's just the opportunity to avoid a lot of these catastrophic outcomes.
Genetic selection and screening of embryos could well change reproductive medicine as we know it, but it also raises serious concerns about society's values and ethics. How we navigate those issues could well determine the future of using genetic tools in reproductive care.